Nope. Let's do that real quick. Wonder if I have to add it to this. There we go. Accept invite. Ah, I forgot to name it. Oh, put it in the wrong place. Airbricks. Know if it'll actually work here. Now, if we just change our URL structure, fuck it. It ends up being something we gotta go fix in types first. Yep, a little bit of effort, but totally worth it. Yeah, that'll work. And yeah, what up, Gearshift? How you doing? And how's it going, Mr. Code? Sorry, I didn't mean to leave you guys hanging. Just trying to make sure I do some of this right. Well, I could have done this a little cleaner. We don't have enough routes yet that automating... doing the find and replace was that necessary. We're gonna have a few things we do want to find and replace when it comes to navigate. So this is poles. So here's the magical thing. I bet eventually we might be able to see that that template literal thing that we were looking at today make its way into something like this. Right, so I think React Navigation could make use of it for like actually being able to do proper URLs. Right, injecting IDs, matching against that stuff. Yeah, that could be useful. Anyway, back to what we're doing. Okay, all those are fixed. Yeah. Sweet. So we get those there, and now we just gotta look for .NET. And what this allows me to do is just have at least somewhat of a nicer URL. And then it allows me to experiment with, can we have slashes and stuff in there? Right, so we can at least get almost proper rounding. I don't know if we can get, like, proper, like, wild cards, or whatever, right? Bunch of those too. Whoops. Alrighty, so we got that little refactor done, right? So now URL linkability is gonna look just a little bit better, right? Right? Polls and teams. They're part of the same view, so they don't actually have a URL change. Not ideal. But, okay. So our next step. Right, on accept invite. We need to do that. That was the end of the albums. Let's do another. And yeah, Thomas Brandon's saying that he's got another album coming out soon. I saw the email. Yeah, we could do it soon. This artist. The last album, too. So, AppRite, what's the other thing we end up needing right off the bat? We need that persistence thing. So we need some state. Thank you. Yes, so we have invite here. Let's get some of the boilerplate from here. Just create a state with a type. Somehow I missed that. Alright, so we already know what it's coming back with. Membership ID. Secret. And team ID. Oh, user ID. So here's the thing. User ID. Whose user ID was that? Right, so let's look. C5AD. What user is that? That is this one. So it creates a brand new account. How is that supposed to work? Damn, Skiz. Yeah, so they've already created a user, so we don't need to make them log in. Okay, well, we're gonna take in those values, right? From the URL using deep linking, it should work. Okay. Yeah, there's something about how we're doing this that I need to really rethink. over here in AppWrite. So if they update their status, it works. I think we're back to square one, where we're gonna need a server-side function to tell if, like, the user is already registered. It's the only way that we can get to it. Okay, here's the next thing we try. I want to verify this about AppWrite. So it does not resend to a user. It's using email. Okay, perfect. I just wanted to make sure it wasn't going to create another user if they hadn't created one yet. Right, so we go down here to the bottom. We should see that critical again. We see accept invite right there. Okay, we do it one more time. So, what? Oh, God. Yeah, that's a crazy one. So that's something to do with our linking, right? Could be a broken page. It actually shows the loading screen. And linking config breaks. Is it the dash? Oh, don't worry. That's why I got this this little like monitor arm thing, so we can get the split keyboard shown again. Is there a way to remove the blue thing? Whatever. Hey, what's up, Blue? How you doing? Okay, so okay, and I think I messed up. So, linking is the only thing that'll work, which means our URLs get borked. So yeah, we can't actually make our URLs that pretty. I just don't like capitalization in my URLs, man. Is that so wrong? I've had a long day and I just hate capitalized URLs, man. Yeah, exactly. Oh, you know what, though? I think we needed that. Wait, that totally works? What? Okay. What's up with the shenanigans? Where's the double slash happening? Did I just do that on my own? Do I have that? Is that just my redirect? No, we only have one. Oh, it's just because of the slashes? Interesting. Okay, so that's just something I gotta do, scrubbing down there. Okay. Why do they escape that, actually? But, whatever. If it'll work without it, we're good to go. I mean, yeah. Are you saying here in this case, if I set the redirect URL to an API endpoint, would it work? No. Yeah, they totally do. Yep. I don't like it. I don't like it. Alright, so. We are at a little over 2 hours in. We need to get up and stretch just a little bit. We figured out what this, what that nightmare bug was, and now we're on this page, and I think we should be able to, you know, exchange our membership and get a token. I don't think we've been given a token yet. Let's go double check. We do see user ID. That is not the same user ID, though. So that's fun. Okay. It's still running. I just haven't put any work into it. I feel like, Grumblr is a quicker process to get up and running in a way than it would be to get Stream Parrot back up to parody. Parody. but yeah. So it works. You can use it. I plan on putting more into it, but I actually think there's a broader market for Grumblr as well. And we're gonna have to name it something better, but yeah, I think as far as like monetization goes, Grumblr's a better focus, especially because I think it's a smaller scope. And it has a bigger market of like people that would be willing to use it. And I want to get the React Native stuff kind of knocked out in a nice clean way as a kata for another project I want to work on that I also think has a much bigger, broader market. Like a project that would benefit from, like, investment type shit. Exactly, yep. Yeah, that one I'll have to work on off stream, at least till it's, like, going. I've written a lot of the back end, actually. I just need to update it to more modern Elixir stuff. Don't reach out. There you go. Yeah, I'd basically just have to rewrite a bunch of stuff. Take what I have written, move it out, call it good. But... Stretch time. Bam. Ooh. Kicking stuff. You know what? Actually, give me just a second. We can get the air conditioning vents off this. Cold enough that I'm just wasting energy. Boy. There we go. Oh, and yeah, stretched. Looking to having, right, so you can keep the same tense. Looking forward to having you join us. Yeah, no worries. Anyone else feel like that's a good edit? Feel like mixing up like tenses is, I don't know, definitely way for like some awkward writing to happen. And I do it all the time too. It was just, yeah, actually putting a critical eye on it. All right, getting these legs going for snowboard season. Sounds good. That's the one you've been working on, huh? Looks like you're right near the end of it, though. Do a couple more, like, passes over.
I like it.
That's a couple tweets, isn't it?
Ooh,
that's good for the legs earlier. Right, let's do some lifts and then call it good. Yep, sounds about right. Alright, do some little circles. Make sure the heart rate's down, and then take a seat. Hmm.